burn today. And everybody knows what the deck really is. It's just, can we count to 20? So, we're going to do a league, see if burn is still a viable deck. Start the match. So, let's see, cool. First game of the day, we definitely want to go first with this deck. Keepable hand. So our goal is always to get something out on the board. So, put pressure on our opponent. What is our opponent on? Taking a lot of damage. Wow. Ooh, don't hurt yourself, dog. So cool, we will play this. Just keep going straight to the head. It'd be terrible if we're playing gets Death Shadow. See, that's why Vexen Devil isn't the best. A lot of times I have spent mana and for a life to get a third off the board. True. Oh, we're gonna get tomorrow, fuck. Okay. So let's see. Like it. Cool, that doesn't do anything for us. They gain reach, so it's pop this, see what we get. So we're gonna go attack all out. The reason for this is because we have, yeah. So now we pair. We need to draw one more card, and our opponent's dead. And we're at 12 life, so we have at least 2 to 3 turns. It's crazy. It's like I see a resurgence in Merfolk recently. It's like my fourth time playing it. So we could just win by burn right now. Let's see. Still gonna swing out. So right now I only see, yeah, okay. Let's do 3 damage. Nope. Don't want to make him survive. But it's only 2, 4, 7 damage right now. So that does definitely hurt. So now they're in a unique position right now. He can't swing all out because of the fear of what my deck can do. Up. 6 damage. Okay. Do we get bailed out? Do we get bailed out? Nope, we don't. Just didn't get it. Let's see, we'll get that right there. I do feel like Vela's Summer is going to be needed. So, what do we take out? I like the creature base. We'll take out, I don't really like a Rift Bolt. Honestly, I think we're just racing. We don't need Veil of Summer right now. We're playing against control, I'll put Veil of Summer in. Let's take out one. Well, I do like these though. One Goblin Guide, Sand Blaze, and those are good. Take our Rift Bolts, stick them all out. And one command. I can dig it, keep. If miss words, can we count to 20? Like that. Okay. So this kind of hurts us just a little bit because we look at the landfall triggers for a Serum Blaze, but do get to destroy this. Let's put that there for now. Everything's an island. Good gracious. So good news that we're still at 20. So we can still, we have time. There's no need to really panic. So our goal here, he's probably gonna play a Lord of Atlantis. Our goal is to Siren Blaze it when it comes into play. So we're gonna fetch. Yep. Just get a mountain. Does he have the kind of spell? It's like Force Negation Man right here. Yep. So we're at 12 right now. Four damage. Wow. Touche, touche. Did not expect to see merfolk. Not enough to win. Alright. Goodness about burn matchups that either you win or lose, so they're over pretty quick. 14. I can keep this. This looks like ad nauseum. And this is a pretty, I think, a bad match of four burn. Because basically we have to stop them from getting to 6 mana. But basically this comes down to a race. Oh yeah, this is definitely Ant. So that's 3 mana. So the only reason we're holding off on some of the burn spells is because that's his Oracle, and Cardi name. So Brass, what about with D name? Interest Grace. Okay. Discard. Hold on, what did he get rid of? Spirit guys. So yep, he's going off. Yep. That's the way the cookie crumbles. So what do we side in here? Destructive Reverie. Never really worry about creatures, so Searing Blaze. Kingo. They don't really use their graveyard, so it's the only thing that can really help us out right here. Yep. Keeping. Okay. Definitely need to get a land first. So they have Ant in their hand, cool. Let's cool, he draws that. But right now, our main goal is trying to do enough damage to our opponent so he can't win. Long story short. Play that, and then we'll swing out again. Swing spirit guide, cool. She has one more, okay. So there's a little bit of good news. When this comes in, he's gonna take 2 damage. It's gonna put him to 7. He's gonna take 4 next turn. So overall, at the end of his turn, he's gonna be at 3. What did he name? What did he name? Let's make this a little bit smaller. Frexen, okay. So I'm assuming with one creature because I don't want him to draw any more cards. Now he's in the negatives. That way I do an infect damage to him. Take 2 damage. Cool. One, two, three, and he has that. So, he's going to draw his whole hand. He did lose some mana already by using Spirit Guides. So, he has a Lightning Storm and 2 Spirit Guides. 1, 2, 3, 4. How many? Hope he doesn't have it. Okay, cool. Hello. Okay. Okay. The trigger still goes on the stack. We're going to Lightning Helix it. Oh, it doesn't matter. What can you do? Oh, 0-2 a burn, not looking good for us. But I will say these matches are freaking quick. So, let's see. Okay. keep. What are we going against? Looks like we're going against Amulet Titan, which will be overall, I think, a good matchup for us. So, pop. Let's get this guy. And then for one, next turn, we're going to drop the, well, again, depending where our opponent plays, Rift Bolt. Another Swiss Spear. Cool. What is he gonna name? Pretty sure Titan. Oh, Scout. Okay. So that's still good for us because obviously we're gonna kill the Scout off. Sandblaze, maximize damage on it. So. We're gonna try and maximize the damage on the ground, so cast her. Cast Goblin Guide. Fetch for a mountain. Suspend this. So I think we're sitting up and he starts to go off. Oh, okay. That right there is irrelevant to us. So definitely Amulet Titan. So we could do bolt on this. What is it? Just target creature gets double strike. No, we'll just do four. And now right there should be enough. Yep, enough to kill him. So with this, obviously Destructive Reverie comes in. Sandblaze is good, but I like Serum Blood better. Those are okay. Yep, I think this is where we're at right here. Alright, just waiting for our opponent right now. So, I do like this. Keep. Obviously turn one, fetch, Swiss Spear. Take less damage as possible. Alright, so play that. We're gonna fetch, get our white source. Once our opponent passes his priority back to us, we'd be great. So let's see, we'll get a. Spend lightning bolt to the face. So now we're set up for a very, very powerful turn on turn three for us. Because Rift Bolt does, so it's swing. So Rift Bolt will do three. So he's already going to be at 14. It's going to be 11. That's going to pair trigger right here. Lightning bolt, lightning bolt. So he's already at. Back up a little bit. Make sure math is okay. So next turn, he's gonna take three from Rift Bolt. Then that's gonna probably trigger for the mentor. Oh, lightning bolt, lightning bolt. That right there is 6 more damage. That's 9. Okay. He's at 13. Okay. Ouch, that does hurt. So we have a lot of damage. So that's good. Good news is that he didn't have the last card, so I'm pretty happy about that. Alright, sometimes you have to get lucky. Yay, so we finally won a game. So, partly luck. See, wow, these matches go really fast. I gotta start extreme burn more. Round four. Yes, we would like to go first. Mulligan. This is definitely keepable. We'll go down a command. So where are we up against? Hey, done dogging. Looks like we're going up against good old Jun. Or land destruction, 1 to 2. Oh no, it's Jun. Mountain. Lightning bolt. So I don't really know how I feel about this matchup. It really depends where our opponent has. I will say definitely doesn't help the fact that we're not drawing any lands. Goodness is, it seems like our opponent doesn't have anything either. So, nice. There's other time for a land to come into play. So I don't think I can risk it. I think I have to kill this off. I think he's trying to cast Blood Red Elf and realize he can't do it. So. Oh, nope. Does something totally different. We'll get rid of Blaze. Quite an evil way to play this game. Yep, Blood Red Elf Cascade trigger. It's a bobble. Love it. Definitely couldn't have been worse. Yep, turn 6, scavenger of the land. So these are the breaks. What can you do? Land? Come on, land. The slow grind. I feel like I'm playing an arena right now. It's quite depressing. What is he doing? Where are you casting? Oh, he brought back ooze. Inquisition, definitely getting a lightning helix. Yeah. Clearly, he's doing it to protect the Skooze. Don't blame him. If we get a lightning bolt. Yeah, could see it. Game's over. That was terrible. So we'll take those out. Put these in. Put the other one in. Don't really like Sam Blaze in this matchup. I'm gonna put in 2 Sam Blood and then 2. Well, should I put? Yeah. Let's put 3 Vela Summers in. Definitely wanna go first. Actually, doable. Swing, what did they get? Terminate, okay. So I think we're sitting pretty good right now. Cool. It's amazing how this card is worth so much money now. Foil. No, let's put this in an awkward position right here. Oh, he draws it. So depending on what our opponent has. We're gonna go get this. To pay 2 life. Yes. At least push them to 9. Remember when this matchup used to be terrible for Jun. Now, with all the life gain, you have collective brutality. Definitely gives him a leg up, but definitely helps him out a lot. Pretty sure Goblin guy's gonna get bolted and wow, fade to push. That sucks for us. So now the good news is we do have lethal in our hand. Bad news is gonna take us 2 turns to do it. So they need a bolt and a push. Because next time we do a hair removal spell. Well, no, I think this is a game for them. They have to be able to basically wipe our board.
What are you chewing on now, dog?
And I don't think they can, so. Yeah. So he has to get a basic. So, yep. Good old scavenger ooze. Okay. Depends on what we draw. Okay, so 3 damage. We see 3 damage, and our creatures get bigger. Again, doesn't really bother us. We're okay. So I would have. You had to block. Thank you. So now it goes like, as long as he doesn't have the Thoughtseize or Inquisition, we should be fine. We're going to try to force our opponent to a very weird spot. K-Command. If there is a K-Command, then we basically lock our opponent out. He's going to shoot this. We're going to discard Lightning Helix. Yep. Get rid of Lightning Helix. That's fine. We play our Eidolon. So as far as I'm concerned, there's no four color spell that can kill this off. Can't cast that. Cool. So all we do is kill that off. Cool. All right, the Hedgetic game 3. He is going first. Does Velocimo even good in this matchup right here? That's the real question. I don't think it is. It's kind of a cool card, but I don't really like Velocimo in it main. I'm going to bring back Rift Bolt. It was... The Velocimo was cool game 2, or because I'm going first. I at least get something on board present, then keep swinging, protect it. I like this, but I feel that this is how I lost game 1. He chose to play first. Hopefully he mulligans. You know what? I'm gonna be stupid. We'll keep. So at least the Pigeon just definitely allows us to keep their cards at bay. Land, up. I feel like we're doing the same thing, deck. I'm pretty sure he has a push or a lightning bolt. Goif. Yep. Okay, Ren is 6, cool. Interesting that he didn't do anything with it, but okay. So that could be a risky move. I'm gonna ignore the running six. And we're just gonna Aether our opponent's head. Interesting, cool. One damage to us, we're okay with that. Oh snap, we finally got the land we need, so let's start going off. Let's suspend. Tender for another 3. So I'm pretty sure he has a Bloodbraid Elf. Alright, he's not drawing anything. A little bit. Don't really know what to play in Modern right now. So here I am playing Burn. So Sambalize, good card. So we're gonna do drop this guy. It was my second, because I like for Modern, my first deck was Merfolk, and then I had a Rakdos Burn deck. I played Dark Confidant Mines, hilarious. They had Dark Confidant in the deck. Never a dull moment. Oh, what up, dog? Cool, I like it. More damage to our opponent. We're definitely going to eat this thing. Yeah. I will say this, like me playing this has basically made the all my games go by really fast. So we're not gonna do Sand Blood. We're gonna do yes, I definitely do. Like I missed the human interaction. And that's something that even though I made a stream, some people watch me, I'm not like a big YouTuber or anything like that, it still kinda sucks. Because there's only so much I can do. I miss human action. Yeah. And I think that's the reason why the guy who made the game called it The Gathering. Because you're bringing people around, have a conversation. And yeah, it's just not, it's not what it used to be. Like, the only reason why I like, well, originally I stopped playing online because I had a kid, and, well, not two. And I wasn't able to always make it to tournaments. Or, I'm not close enough to get, call them, freak Huge game. Oh, yeah. I definitely understand that. What is he casting now? Another Ren of Six. Cool. Ping me. Yep. I definitely understand that. So what we're gonna do... He does have a bolt. So, How do we want to play this? You can't. So, like, I understand why a lot of the stores shut down just because for health reasons, so. Let's see, let's fetch first. Let's get this guy. Yes. Let's. Yep, exile all cards, draw a card. Yeah. I have been swinging around trying to buy a few cards just because trying to keep the... I do want the stores to be around while I'm still there. I gotta go... I went to GG when I was on lunch break to get something from there. Then I'm probably gonna go to Angry and get something from there too. So I'm just hoping they're able to weather the storm so that... Yeah. Yeah. Definitely. I think it's gonna go on for a while too. I think like it's gonna be 21 like you say. There's supposed to be another spike happening. Granted, I haven't done my due diligence and research yet, but doesn't look good. Let's see. So the only reason why we're holding off is because our opponent may have Weather the Storm, and I'm trying to avoid that card. All right. Do we win? Does he have removal? Alright, let's see. Does he have it? Nope, he doesn't. Woo! Dang. Yeah. I really, really do hope that we're able to go back to normal. I heard some good news about a vaccine, but then again, like, news always talks about... It's always bringing up, like, the vaccine is going to be... is close. The vaccine is close. I do hope it does hit soon. So. Yeah. Yeah, I do hope so. It would have snapped back. So we're gonna get rid of this. Did I go first? Nope. Never go first. I think it will. I think it's gonna show. It's gonna do a lot, and it's gonna show Americans that we need to be better prepared for things like this. Play this. Play you. So, I'm all for it. The vaccine, I knew, watching the news, I did see that they're going to try to move more things to America for transportation, like making products, so we're going to rely on other countries, which I think is overall a good thing, helps with more jobs. Yeah, definitely liking that. So, we're playing against Bank Control. How this one goes. All right, we'll do that. Yeah, we're gonna do this right here. So the reason why we're doing this instead of everything else, like the Goblin guys, because Lava Spike. Both come 2/3. That's 10 damage right there. And if he fetches and blocks, he's still going to take damage from fetching. He's at 9 effectively right now because of the fetch. So. Oh, this may not be bent. This may be blue. White. Yeah, and also, like, our goal is I don't want my opponent to dig through his deck at all. We're gonna pop right here. We're gonna get a stomping ground. Yes. Collect your fortress against the land. Oh yeah. People usually forget about that, but. We're still okay with that. Again, we're still. That's still 6 damage right there. Got it. You kind of spell Lightning Helix. Snapcaster. Cool. Probably blocking a Goblin Guide. So we're still pushing our narrative pretty well against our opponent right now. So let's see. Try to force our opponent to have something. Okay. I'll give them 10. That was very, very good for them. Definitely annoying, but we should be able to get past them just with this right here. At least we're killing this creature off. They're at 1, so we took away all their fetching, and they have to respond to this creature some type of way. Yeah. So this is where gonna be a little risky taking out the rift bolts. We'll put Vela Cimarron. Take out 2 Sand Blaze. I'm pretty sure he's gonna have some type of gain life card. So this is what we're going with right here. Okay, so do we keep this? Do we keep this? Do we keep this? I honestly would like to have a creature turn 1. But isn't that bad? We'll keep it. We have 2 ways to deck thin ourselves with fetching. We're going to draw a card. Ouch. So I did not see Leyline of Sanctity. Definitely hurts here. So it is a little sad, but darn it, Dan, let me do what I wanted to do. I'm still gonna play it out, and the reason why I'm playing it out is I want to see what my opponent really has. What do you sideboard in? So I'll probably play 2 or 3 turns, and then if I don't get anything, then I'm just gonna pass. We'll go to game 3. No. Whew. Yep, that would definitely be it, but as we see, my deck is betraying me. I love it. Yeah, we're gonna concede this one. Alright, so going to game 3. Oh, bring you went back in. Good news is we're going first, so Vela Cimarron is not that good. Oh yes. Up. Oh, perfect hand. Cool, we don't care about that card. Yeah, I definitely feel that. So, good news is let me see a dispute. No one cares about that. So my goal right now, we're just trying to keep pressure on him. I'm pretty sure he has a spell snare. And right now, we're just gonna keep this pounding him with these creatures. We have the cool. Critical command, great. Well, that's the reason why I'm kind of holding on to the destructive reverie. My goal is to pressure my opponent so that he has to deal with this. This is he's at 13 life. This right here very well could kill him. So as long as I keep pressuring him, take his focus on this, and then I blow up his enchantment. Now this is better for me. So let's see. Swing again. Monastery, mentor, cool. Draw a card, then draw a card equal to another. Oh. Okay. That goes to his hand, cool. So now we're gonna drop the Eidolon because for him to respond with the mentor, he's gonna take 3 damage. Which puts him at a disadvantage. He's gonna f now, yeah. It's not looking good for him right now. Play another land. Cool. Yep, so he has to get a plains. Oh, he didn't. Interesting. Let's see. So we're gonna blow it up. So cool. It's taking all this damage right here. It's gonna take 2 right there. Kind of spell that. I take 2. Then he takes 2. Oh, he's gonna control that. Okay. What is in this deck? Let's see. So, darn it. Should have swung. I misplayed right there. Should have swung. Me swinging keeps the pressure on him. Good news about the Eidolon right here is that he still can't do anything. Yeah, I should have fetched. But he's still in a really bad spot. I'll just. You're not dumb. I misclicked. Let's see. All that we can get is a mountain. Cool, I don't mind taking 2 damage. I'm pretty sure he's a Snapcaster. Probably. Huh, do we path our own thing? Put him at 2. Yep. That's targeting that. All right, cool. Yep. So we went 3-2 overall, pretty fun. We lost against Murfolk and Ad Nauseam, but we beat Amulet Titan and Jund. Band control, well, I guess just regular control then. We had blue white control. But overall, just want to do a quick round. Put this over here. Overall, I really like it a lot. I was able to use Veil of Summer, but I see why it's in there. I like the green just for the the artifact and enchantment destruction. Definitely love regular Pogenesis. Definitely helps us out a lot. So overall, it was a good deck. I have a YouTube page called Magic Fun. Please subscribe to it. But this will be up on Monday because I had to wait 24 hours when I do streaming. But all right, I'm gonna try to do a stream later on today at 8 or probably 9. So hope to see you then. Take care.